Chitrakethu. Chitrakethu was the king of Surasena, a province near Mathura. He was well learned, devoted to the Lord, and righteous in his actions. He was in good health, prosperous in wealth, and famous among kings. He had several wives, numbering in thousands, all young and beautiful and healthy. But he had no issues. One day, sage Angira arrived at his palace as a guest, and in the course of conversation inquired the king the reason for his despondency. The king explained to him that he had been bestowed with health, wealth, and sovereignty, but was childless. Sage Angira heard him sympathetically and arranged for a sacrifice to please the god Tvashta. He gave the payasam that was got out of the sacrificial fire equally to the king and his eldest queen Kritadyuti, and said that the king would have a son through the eldest queen, who would be a source of joy as well as of grief to the king, and went away. Accordingly, Queen Kritadyuti gave birth to a son, and the child was growing robust day by day. The king was too fond of the only son, and consequently of the eldest queen too. The other queens became jealous of the eldest because she was having all the attention of the king, who had entirely neglected them all. They decided that the son was the cause for the special affection of the king. They engaged a nurse and through her poisoned the son secretly. Without any apparent cause, the son died all of a sudden. The king, the queen, the dependents, and all the people in the city were weeping. Just then, the sage Angira arrived there along with sage Narada. He saw the king being immersed in sorrow and inquired of him, "Who are you? Who is this boy that is lying dead? How are you related to him? What was he in his previous birth? What will he be in his next birth? How were you related to him in the previous birth? How will he be related to you in the next birth? These jivas, souls, are like sand in the river, which come together by the floods and pass away with the next flood. It is all Maya. It is all God's dispensation. The soul is eternal. The bodies change, they come and go. The soul is not dependent on the bodies." When the king heard these words, he opened his eyes and begged to know who those two sages might be. Angira told him his identity as the one who gave him the son, and the other was introduced as the celestial sage Narada. Sage Angira further said, "With great expectation I came to you on the previous occasion to impart the highest knowledge to you, but you were not fit to receive it, being anxious for a son. Now you got a son and you have lost a son, but you are as you ever was, and yet you are having an additional agony with you. The same agony you will surely have by longing for wife, son, house, riches, power, property, kingdom, sovereignty, etc. They are all ephemeral and are only sources of grief. It is all an illusion. Even this body is subject to many afflictions and agonies. Therefore, investigate and reject the unreal world and abide by the self." Meanwhile, Narada addressed the soul of the dead son and asked him to come back into the body and enjoy the balance of life as a king's son and rule over the kingdom. The jiva spoke through the body, "In which birth of mine were these king and queen, my father and mother? The bodies are born out of karma. How am I dependent on them? The jiva is always free. He has neither birth nor death, no relations, no attachments. I am the self, everlasting, all-powerful, self-illuminating. The supreme creates the prakriti and with the gunas. But he is only a witness, unaffected, both with the cause and the effect." Having said these words, the jiva disappeared. A few days after the dead body was disposed of, Narada initiated the king with the sacred mantra, by meditating on which for 7 days the king obtained supreme beatitude. His mind became pure. He reached the abode of Adisesha and perceived the ancient Purusha, Lord Vishnu, and praised him. The Lord told Chitrakethu that he had attained the highest state. I am the Self, the inner controller. You are me. I pervade the whole universe. Like a dream, out of me, all these souls and the relationships are created. You should have discrimination to know yourself and cultivate devotion to me, the Self. By that, you will gain knowledge and wisdom and will then attain perfection. So saying, the Lord disappeared. Chitrakethu, by his perfection, leaving his human body, became the chief of the celestials called Vidyadharas and was wandering in a celestial aerial car wherever he liked. One day, Chitrakethu, the chief of Vidyadharas, was passing in his aerial car over Mount Kailas. He saw Lord Shiva in an assembly of sages sitting with his spouse Uma on his lap, embracing him. Chitrakethu laughed and said aloud that the Lord was sitting in an assembly of Brahmavadins with his lady on his lap. He could have embraced her in private. Lord Shiva heard his remarks, laughed and kept quiet. All the sages were silent. Goddess Uma retorted in anger, "Is this fellow the dictator of righteousness to the Lord? Do not all the sages, Brahma and others, know what is righteous and what is not? This chief is arrogant and is not fit to approach the lotus feet of Lord Shiva or Lord Vishnu, and so let him be born as a demon." Chitrakethu heard these words patiently, came down from his car and prostrated to Goddess Uma and said, "O Devi, I accept your command with joined hands. I do not beg for excuse, for what is pronounced by divinities like you is all predestined. The Jiva suffers joy or sorrow according to the dispensation of the Lord, who has no partiality. Ignorant people think that they are suffering, etc. But really, the soul does not suffer anything. It's only a witness. It has no kinsmen or enemies. On account of the Maya of the Supreme, Prakriti is created with three gunas, which out of ignorance suffers joy or sorrow, bondage or liberation, etc. So I do not feel the curse pronounced by you. I only beg to be excused for speaking a plain truth," and he went away. Lord Shiva addressed Goddess Uma and said, "My dear, you have seen the greatness of the devotees of Lord Narayana. They have no fear from any quarters, even from death, for hell or heaven are equal to them. It is his Maya that has given them the body to suffer joy or pain. The suffering is all out of ignorance. Like seeing the snake in the rope, the joy and pain are attributed to the soul. A devotee of Vishnu finds no difference as high or low. They have no fear from anybody. I am also a devotee of Lord Vishnu, and so I was unperturbed by his remarks." By these words of Lord Shiva, Goddess Uma was pacified. Chitrakethu, though capable of giving a counter curse to the goddess, did not attempt at retaliation. He was very soon born as the demon called Vritrasura out of the sacrificial fire of Tvashta to take vengeance against the gods. Chitrakethu, though born as a demon, did not lose his spiritual knowledge and wisdom, which he had gained out of the association of great sages like Angira and Narada. He was conscious that he was the witness for the different births and modifications of the body.